Hello guys, this is the 2023 Hyundai Elantra SEL. So for 2023, nothing was changed. This is just a carryover, so the car is going to look the same. And this thing looks very nice and sharp in black. It does have black rims. And there is three trims for the 2023 model year so far. I'm pretty sure that they're going to add more trims like the N line and the N Elantra. But this one is the SEL, finished in Phantom Black. Does look nice and sharp, but let's go ahead and take it on a PUV test drive and see how this 2023 Elantra drives. So here is the interior of this 2023 Hyundai Elantra SEL. This is the mid trim and is finished in Phantom Black. The inside is finished in gray, and this gray color actually looks very good. There is a good amount of plastic here, but as long as you don't touch them, that's fine. But interior looks pretty good. There is an 8-inch screen. There is a 4.2-inch screen right there. On the right. Let me go ahead and show you the backup camera. Backup camera resolution is all right. It is nice and wide. But let's go ahead and take this Elantra SEL on a drive and see how it does. So driving this 2023 Hyundai Elantra, as I said, this one is basically, this 2023 is basically just a carryover from the 2022, so nothing was changed. I'm gonna compare this Elantra to the Civic, to the new Civic, because I really did not like the way how the new Civic drove on the highway. It was too loud. The Civic was nice and responsive, but I just hated the fact that it was very loud on the highway. So I'm gonna go ahead and test this Elantra and see how it is and compare it to the new Civic, because it does compete against it. As I said, the interior looks good amount of plastic. There is an 8-inch screen. It does have Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Steering wheel has a nice design to it. It's not wrapped in leather. I really wish it was, but it is a $23,000 car, so that's fine. But the steering wheel is nice and thick, aggressive, which I like. Very nice and responsive. Does have a naturally aspirated engine, so doesn't have a turbocharged engine. I'll talk about the engine, the horsepower and torque numbers when I hop on the highway. Let's go ahead and put this Elantra in sport mode. There's three modes you could choose from. There is normal, sport, smart, and gauges look good. Finished in red for this SEL trim, which is nice. And this car overall actually feels nice and sporty, which I like. Let's go ahead and do an acceleration right here. Definitely nice and responsive. Very confident for a non-sporty sedan. So, suspension setup is perfect. I love the fact that the suspension is nice and comfortable, but at the same time, it handles very good. So good job, Hyundai, for making a very good suspension like this. Second thing, this engine is nice and responsive. Definitely pushed me back to the seat. And yeah, sure, this engine doesn't really have a lot of power, but the weight of this car makes up for it. I think this Elantra is around 3,200, if I'm not mistaken. I'll go ahead and correct that in the bottom of the screen. But seriously, very responsive. So under the hood, there is a 2.0 naturally aspirated four-cylinder engine. It is connected to an IVT transmission. This IVT transmission is quick when you put it in manual mode, and the IVT transmission is like a CVT transmission. It is very similar, but it's slightly different, but it is nice and responsive, so I really like that. Super quick. I know those gears are basically fake gears, but very impressed with this IVT transmission. This engine produces 147 horsepower and 132 pound-feet of torque. And yeah, sure, those numbers are not really a lot on paper, but this car feels quick, which I like. And again, guys, this Elantra is light, so that's why it feels nice and responsive. But I am truly impressed with the way how it accelerates and the way how it drives, and I definitely love this Elantra more than the new Civic. So Hyundai did a great job with the way how this thing drives, the way how it handles, and yeah, overall, such a beautiful car. Very, very nice sounding engine. Again, guys, this IVT transmission is quick. This screen has Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Hard buttons on the left and right. I love the fact that there is a tune knob, volume knob. Here is the engine start stop, located in a very nice place. Climate controls are very easy to use. Fan speed, automatic function. It does have dual climate controls. Two USBs, 112 volt, a nice storage place. And there's two cup holders. There is this small tiny cup holders that they, I think, give. And yeah, overall, good amount of storage places. Not a big fan of this handle, kind of makes the interior a little bit small. Plastic, this is actually nice and soft, but it does look like plastic, but it does have some softness to it. Not a big fan of the flat black screen, the surrounding, it just doesn't look that good. Steering wheel has a really nice design to it. I really like what Hyundai did. Door looks good. Plastic. The armrest is soft, a little bit on the harder side. This whole thing actually is nice and soft. Door handle looks good. Window switches, mirror controls, everything looks right. The front, the driver window is automatic up and down. The steering wheel is extremely light, which I like. And yeah, overall, this thing is very, very good. And honestly, I can't even hear the engine on. Feels like it's, yeah, it is very, very quiet. Seriously, such a quiet, comfortable interior. I love the fact that the windows are nice and big. And I'm gonna go ahead and hop on the highway, but I am seriously impressed with the fact that it's nice and comfortable. Quiet on the highway, very refined. There is barely any road noise, if any. And I love the fact that there is no wind noise at all. So Hyundai killed it with the Elantra. Much, much better than the Civic. And it's just sad that Honda been making cars for a really long time and mess up the road noise on the Civic. The Civic is such a beautiful car. The new Civic is really, really nice, but they messed up on the road noise or the tire noise. So definitely I would choose the Elantra over the Civic, because the Civic is just too loud on the highway. Very responsive. Does have blind spot monitoring system, which I like. Does have lane keeping assist, emergency braking, blind spot monitoring system, lane keeping assist, and steering assist. And yeah, seriously, very, very nice for a $23,000 car. And it does not have adaptive cruise control, I really wish it did. But again, guys, this is a $23,000 car and this is a mid-trim, so I think that's completely fine. And this thing keeps pulling. The more you accelerate, the more it pushes you back to the sea, or the more it keeps going. Blind spot monitoring system alarms you and it blinks on the mirror, which is nice. That 4.2 inch screen looks good. Let's go ahead and test the steering assist. So as I said, guys, it does have cruise control but does not have adaptive cruise control. So the steering will turn, the car will stay in the lanes, but it won't accelerate and come to a complete stop. So you basically have to accelerate and brake yourself, but it does have steering assist. Hyundai safety system is very good, so the steering assist is good and their adaptive cruise control is good, but this one is not equipped with it. But overall, they do a great job with their safety features. If you guys are curious about the fuel economy numbers, they are very, very impressive. 30 in the city, 40 on the highway, and 34 combined. And yeah, seriously, I'm very impressed with the MPGs. This thing is seriously comfortable, quiet. Windows are nice and big. Seeing out of the back is good. Steering wheel is nice and light. Let's go ahead and test the brakes. Very, very good. They have a really nice bite to them, and I love the fact that they're nice and confident. The pedal does not sink in, it's not hard, it's not too soft, it's just the perfect feeling. I do have mixed feelings about the gloss black rims. The design looks alright, but yeah, I'm not a big fan of the gloss black. I want to go ahead and do an acceleration right here from a dead stop. It is in smart mode, but let me go ahead and just put it in sport mode. The seats are nice and comfortable, good amount of space. So a little bit of delay from a dead stop, but that's completely fine. I just love the fact that this thing is responsive. This IVT transmission is very, very good. And this thing feels and sounds very sporty. So let's go ahead and test the turning radius. So as I mentioned, the steering wheel is nice and light. It's extremely light. Turning radius is very, very good. And yeah, seriously, the steering is super, super light. So good job Hyundai for making a nice light steering wheel. This definitely makes this car super easy to drive in small parking lots. So for $23,000, you are getting a ton of features. But something that is missing is the adaptive cruise control. If the adaptive cruise control was included in this, SEL trim. I think it would have been nice. The Civic offers all the safety features on all the trims, so that's what I like about Honda. But with Hyundai, they basically removed the adaptive cruise control. I think it should have been standard on all the trims, and I feel like when they do like a facelift or something, maybe they'll just include them. But I am truly impressed with the way how this thing drives. The MPGs are very, very good. This 2.0 naturally aspirated is seriously responsive, quick, and I really like it. And the sound that is coming out of it is just very good. MPGs, 30 in the city, 40 highway, and 34 combined. Those numbers are seriously good. And the suspension, the handling, the acceleration, the braking, and every single thing about this Elantra is perfect. So I really like what Hyundai did, and I would definitely buy the Elantra over the new Civic. I hope you guys enjoyed this POV test drive of this 2023 Hyundai Elantra. If you guys are around and if you guys are interested, make sure to come and see Moody here at Key Hyundai in Milford. And if you guys are interested in seeing more videos like this, please like and subscribe, because it does help a lot. And as always, I'll see you next time.